All right, thanks for listening to this lesson on derivatives and differentiation in R. We're going to be using R to compute derivatives, and just so this is clear, the command we're going to be using isn't a standard part of R per se, it's a part of this mosaic package that we use in this course. And so if you ever have trouble using the basic command, one of the first things to do is check over here in your Packages tab, do you have the mosaic package listed, and is this check mark checked off so that the package is activated? If you don't have the package there and activated, you won't be able to do the commands that we're using in this lesson. So let's start out. The command that we use to do differentiation is just the capital letter D, standing for derivative. So if I type a command like g equals d of x squared twiddle x, this means I would like to differentiate the function x squared with respect to x. That creates a new function, the derivative function, and we're going to be saving that into something we can use called g. So g should now be a function which is the derivative of x squared. Now I happen to know that the derivative of x squared is the function 2x, so that if I plug in 1 into g, I should get out 2 times 1, which is 2, and I do. If I plug in g of 3.5, I should get out 2 times 3.5, which is 7. Okay, we could even look inside the function g if we want. And to see what's inside of a function, you just type the function's name. And it tells us g is a function that takes an input and gives you back 2 times that input. Now, we're seeing a nice formula for the derivative here because it so happens that x squared is a function where it's easy to find a formula for the derivative. But that's not always the case. So we could do another example. We could type h is going to be the derivative of the sine of the absolute value of x minus 3. And we would like to differentiate that whole thing with respect to x. Well, that's kind of a nasty function. It's not so easy to write down a formula for the derivative. And if we now ask what's inside this derivative function h, we see a bunch of technical-looking things that basically tell us that R is going to evaluate that derivative a different way, other than finding a simple formula. But it still is going to do it. And so h still is the derivative of that function sine of absolute value of x minus 3, and we can plug into h and get numerical values, right? No problem. Something else I want to point out is that so far, when we've been computing derivatives, we've been typing the function that we want to differentiate directly into the derivative command. Like we typed in x squared here, we typed in sine of absolute value of x minus 3 over here. But you can also differentiate a function that you've previously defined. So if I said something like f equals make fun x cubed as a function of x, well, f is just the cubic function, right? So f of 2 should be 8. And I can now take that function that I've previously defined and differentiate it. So suppose I want to call the derivative f prime. I could say f prime equals d of f of x differentiated with respect to x. And I happen to know that the derivative of the function x cubed is 3x squared. So for instance, if I plugged in 2 into f prime, I should get out 3 times 2 squared, which is 12. And let's check that. Okay, great, it's working. We can do examples that include parameters, functions that have parameters. So let's do a quick example of this. I can define a function s2, and I would like for it to be the derivative of a times the sine of 2 times pi times t divided by p plus a constant with respect to t. So what the d command will do is take this entire function and it'll differentiate it with respect to t, leaving the other unknown things alone, right? It'll leave a and p and c alone. Okay, now if we actually wish to evaluate this, we need to define or we need to give R values of all of those other parameters, right? So even though S2, which is the derivative of that function, is a function of t, if I type in something like S2 of 3.7, I get a complaint that A is missing, and that's because we haven't told R what's the value we want to use for that parameter A. Similarly, we have to define P and C. So we could do something like S2 of T equals 3 is what we would like to plug in for T. But we could say A equals 2, P equals 10, and C equals 4. Okay, we gotta give it numerical values, and then we get a numerical value back for the derivative. Something else we could do is take this function created as a derivative, and we could plot it. So we can say plot fun, and we would like to plot this function S2. It's a function of t, and we're going to set the parameters equal to a is 2, p is going to be 10, and c is going to be 4. And we would like to plot that whole thing as a function of t. And let's say that we would like to see t going over the range from 0 to 20. Okay, and if we execute this command, we see a nice plot showing up over here. And it's the derivative of the function, a sine 2 pi t over p plus c, where we've set a to 2, p to 10, and c to 4. Something else to point out about the derivative function is that the derivatives that it produces are partial derivatives. So let's be really clear about this. Suppose we have a simple function of two variables. Let me call it q is going to be make fun of, and our function will be x squared plus y cubed, and that is a function of x and y. Okay. Well, if I would like to ask for the partial derivative with respect to x, I could type something like qx equals d of q of x and y with respect to x. Okay, that's the partial derivative with respect to x. I can try to evaluate it. So if I say something like qx, well, actually it's helpful to look inside this function qx. It tells us that it's a function of two things, x and y. So if we ask for qx at, 2, I get a complaint because we haven't told it an x value and a y value. If I type something like qx of 2, 17, what I'm going to get is the x derivative of the function q when x is 2 and y is 17, and there's a value for it. Okay. Similarly, we could compute the partial derivative with respect to y. So I'm going to arrow up to my previous command and say qy is the derivative of q with respect to y. And we can ask what's qy at different values, negative 2, comma, negative 3, and we get a numerical answer. Okay, finally, one last thing to point out is that you can take a derivative of a derivative to get a second derivative using r. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this. Let's define a function. Let's call it Fred equals make fun sine of x as a function of x. Okay, so just to make sure we've got the right thing, I could say plot fun Fred of x for x dot lim equals range 0 to 7, I'm going to say. Okay, so oops. I forgot to tell it what it's a function of. Fred of x as a function of x. There we go. And here's our plot of the sine function. And suppose we'd like to differentiate it a couple times. We could say d Fred equals the derivative of Fred of x with respect to x. That's going to be the first derivative of the sine function. Okay? If we would like to take a second derivative, we can type this syntax. We could type something like dd Fred equals the derivative of Fred of x with respect to x and x. That means differentiate with respect to x two times, okay? And that's going to give us a different function. We can go ahead and make a plot of that if you'd like to see what it looks like. We could say plot fun dd Fred of x as a function of x for x lim equals range 0 to 7, and we'll get a plot of the second derivative of the sine function going from 0 to 7. And here's what it looks like. All right, that's it for this lesson. Thank you for listening.